February 15th, 2021, a massive Arctic storm is working its way across the country, about to bear down on nearly one-third of the entire United States. It's 1 a.m., and mayhem is about to begin. Inside the electric grid control room, highly experienced operators intensely monitor power flow demands on a massive plasma screen that covers the front wall, as well as on countless smaller screens that line the surrounding desks. Lights are flashing, alarms are going off in every single direction, every sound having a very specific and urgent meaning. Phones are ringing, everyone is communicating. Even the President of the United States has called in to see how the situation is unfolding. But there is a huge problem. Every single weather event is different, and no matter how prepared we are, no one is quite sure what is about to happen. Suddenly, as the storm begins to intensify, power lines go down. Gas pipes begin to freeze. Grid conditions get tighter and tighter and tighter until the power goes out. In February of 2021, 170 million people from Indiana to Texas were affected. 10 million people were without power, and 246 people, roughly the size of this room, lost their lives. Did it have to be this way? No, I don't believe so. But I'm not here to talk about what should have happened. Rather, I'm here to talk about what can be done to reduce the chance of such a devastating event occurring again. During my 4 years working as an electrical engineer at a grid operator, I became obsessed with the evolution of our power grid. Currently, we have three power grids in the United States. The Eastern Interconnect, which is everything east of the Rocky Mountains. The Western Interconnect, everything west of the Rocky Mountains. And the Texas Interconnect. These three grids mostly operate in isolation, and you can't meaningfully move power between them in times of need, like the 2021 Texas winter storm. This is why we need to have a singular national power grid. Now, connecting these grids will not be easy. It will require states working together, something that I must admit, we are not good at. But the benefits are more than worth it, and I see three huge opportunities moving forward. A singular national power grid will, one, promote decarbonization, two, increase reliability, and three, enable innovation. But in order for us to seize on these opportunities, we need to talk about something that doesn't often make the news. We need to talk about transmission. Transmission lines are specialized power lines designed to carry large amounts of power over long distances, essentially serving as energy highways. They are the backbone of all three US grids, and all three grids are dependent on them. But the problem is, there are actually very few transmission connection points between the three grids, representing less than 0.13% of all energy transmission. This tiny amount of connection restricts the operator's ability to meaningfully move power between the three grids in times of need. In order to truly connect the three grids, we need to invest hundreds of billions of dollars in transmission build-out so that we can effectively move energy across the US. Now, this may seem like a monumental task, but projects of this scale have been achieved across the history of humanity. Thousands of years ago, Romans built 11 aqueducts that brought fresh flowing water continuously into Rome, as far as 57 miles away. Right here in the US, a little over 100 years ago, the Transcontinental Railroad was built. This railroad reduced the travel time from New York to San Francisco from 6 months to just 83 hours. Imagine what that must have been like, being in that Roman village, having your first taste of fresh flowing water from the aqueduct, or being in New York at the turn of the century, walking into a market and picking up and smelling your first Florida orange. These two seemingly monumental tasks changed humanity for the better. And now the next task is ahead of us, a singular national power grid. And its potential is powerful. Which brings me to our first opportunity of a singular national power grid, promoting decarbonization. Building transmission lets us move clean, renewable energy across the US. This means we can build wind where it's windiest, we can build solar where it's sunniest, and we can move that energy around to those who need it. As shown in this graphic here, the places in the US with the largest wind and solar potential are often far away from the population centers that need that energy. Last year, in California alone, over 125 million kilowatt hours of clean, renewable energy, which is enough to power the city of San Francisco for a week, was wasted because it could not be moved to those who need it. A recent McKinsey report found that in order for the US to achieve its renewable and emission reduction goals, the transmission grid would need $450 billion in capital investment between now and 2030. Now, this may seem like a large investment, but the National Renewable Energy Laboratory found that by uniting the electric grids through a build-out of transmission, we would see $2.50 in benefits for every dollar in cost. Over time, this translates to lower electricity bills for you and for me. But I want you to think about this all from more than just an investing point of view. I want you to think about it in terms of our second opportunity of a singular national power grid, increased reliability. Currently, more than 70% of our transmission lines are over halfway through their useful life. This means that 70% of our grid is reliant on technology deployed in the mid-1900s. Relying on this aging legacy infrastructure increases the vulnerability for the US and increases our risk of blackouts, according to the Department of Energy. By building new transmission, we're able to not only shore up this existing vulnerability, but also better help each other out during times of need, like hurricanes, heat waves, and winter storms. Reliability means that hospitals, nursing homes, and other essential healthcare services can continue to operate during these times of emergency. Imagine if you or a loved one were in the hospital, dependent on life-saving technology, and the power goes out. There is only so much fuel in the backup generators, and you have no idea when the power will come back on. Reliability in this instance can mean the difference between life and death. But once we are able to reliably connect with each other, we can finally take advantage of our third opportunity of a singular national power grid, enabling innovation. A nationally connected grid would supercharge the movement towards clean tech solutions. Every day, technology is becoming more and more advanced, and our grid needs to keep up. From large generation sources like wind, solar, and nuclear, to new grid technologies like smart homes, electric vehicles, and distributed energy resources, every day more technology is becoming connected to the grid, and transmission is at the heart of it all. A singular national power grid would foster a competitive energy market by facilitating electricity exchange across regions. This would drive down prices, forcing us to innovate technologies that promote efficient, sustainable energy systems. Similar to the market expansion caused by the railroads in the 19th century, drastically expanding electricity markets will spark a wave of innovation and investment like never before. Okay, so I know what you're thinking. This sounds like a great idea, Joe. But California connecting with Texas? No way. But there are already examples of electric grids connecting across countries. Countries with different languages, cultures, and governments. Just this past year, over $900 million was just invested connecting the Italian electric grid to Tunisia. This energy bridge connecting the European and African power systems will reduce Italy's dependence on Russian natural gas and increase their market potential. The US needs to catch up and invest in its own potential. If countries from different continents can work together to connect across the Mediterranean, then we can work together to connect across state lines. The technology, is already here. The engineering, already solved. All that is needed for a singular national power grid is for people to invest in its long-term potential. So if you are sitting here and wondering, what can I do? The answer is simple. Anytime you hear someone talk about their energy plans, whether it's your local utility or your local representative, make sure you ask them about transmission. Make sure they are thinking about how we move our power, not just how we make it. Because the world is becoming more connected every single day. And it's up to us to decide whether we want to be a part of that connection or risk being alone in the dark. The next big storm is coming. But it can be different this time. Because the next big change, a singular national power grid, it's coming too. And it will connect us like never before. Thank you.